Hi guys, this is Claudia here from Metal Days 2016 for We Don't Care magazine, and we have the honor to talk to Dark Funeral.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, you have a new album out now, and my question is, like, is there anything that you in the process of making it have different thoughts about it than in the past?
Yeah, already when we were done with the last record, I had some ideas that I wanted to improve on work on for the next one.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you can have ideas, but what's gonna come out in the end is you know can't really predict that.
Right.
But one thing was I wanted to work on more rhythmic parts,
mm-hmm.
both on the guitars and the drums, make the song more alive and. Yeah, and maybe a little bit more dynamic. And I think, you know, we managed pretty good in that the end of the day. So I was kind of surprised myself, because at Piers I was like, I didn't really know what to expect on the record, but
mm-hmm.
I just kept on writing. And when I listened to the final stuff, I was like, yeah, to my surprise, we managed to do pretty good on what I wanted to improve.
Yeah.
Even more, you know, some stuff are even way different than I was expecting, you know,
mm-hmm.
technique-wise. For example, there's one song called To Carve Another Wound. It's very different, my kind of style, but
mm-hmm.
but I'm glad I just let it go and I went with the flow on that one, because it brought me to a new level of, you know, technology
mm-hmm.
and you know, turns that I can and keep on improving for, you know, future records.
Right. So was it hard for you when you were writing in the process, like, to decide what really to do, or did you just sometimes write and then put it away and then get back to it
I keep on writing, you know. When I get some ideas, I record it in my home studio,
mm-hmm.
then let it be, and then I, you know, when I have the feeling for it, I go back, see if I can, you know, keep on working on it,
mm-hmm.
improve it, or, you know, sometimes you manage to find another part that fits together, and then, you know, in the end, everything can be totally different, because you got a totally new vibe and feel for it, but I realized that everything I come up with, even if I don't really like it from the beginning, it's always a seed to, you know, it's got to be a reason I had the idea of just that one thing, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I see it as a seed of, you know, something that can keep on growing, you know. And that's the way I work. And when I have enough material, when I feel like, okay, now I can really start to, you know, focus one song at a time and
mm.
finalize them. For this record, I went more with the flow than just, you know, my fixed idea how things has to be,
mm-hmm.
you know. There was many times I felt like, I can't do like this. But then it's, you know, at the same time I told myself, you know, it's the right feeling that I'm looking for, you know, so just fucking, you know, let's just do it. So I went more with the flow and with the feeling on this record, which I think, you know, made a difference in the final result.
Is it sometimes that you have, like, old stuff somewhere in the drawer and it comes out and appears to you that, okay, this is the time now it fits? Or is it like you use your parts and the others is just gone?
No, I always save ideas,
mm-hmm.
because, you know, as I said, you know, it's the seed to something that might turn out to something great in the end. So you never know. I you know, that's stuff I learned over the years when I've been writing. That before I was like, I threw away fucking, you know, even stuff the other guys was like, you're fucking stupid, this is really good. And I was like, no, fuck it, delete.
Ooh.
You know, so, and I promised both myself and the other guys that I won't press the delete anymore.
Thanks.
It's always a, you know, you go through a really, you know, really tough time when you're in a creating process and you really dig yourself deep in a black hole, and it's just a, you know, really tough period, but you know, in the end of the tunnel, you know, when you have created a song or something and you feel good about it, then it's just such a relief, you know. Mm-hmm. So.
And about the term of stage persona, there's some people who say, well, I just go out stage, I am who I am, and that's it. And others who have like a character, a figure that is within a certain framework. What does it feel like for you going on stage?
I don't know. I've been doing this for so long time, you know. So it's like, of course, you get in a certain mood when you're getting ready for stage, and then
yeah,
finally
sure.
meet the crowd, and you hear the intro starts, and you know, you just get that, you know, special vibe and feeling for things. It's hard to describe, but of course, you set yeah. a certain mood when you go on stage, and it's not. I don't feel like I do every time I go on stage. It's not I feel like that 24/7, but of no. course it's me. It's not an act for me, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, this is who I am, you know, take it or leave it.
It's and, like your person.
Exactly, and the more retarded and crazy I go on stage, the better I feel about it, I guess, you know. And the faster we play, the better, you know.
And,
but, yeah, I don't know, you can, you know, just go with the feeling when you're on stage, and whatever happens, happens. I can't really.
So you're into the music, really?
Of course, I go fucking full throttle with it, you know. It's like the other guys too, so you know, this is. It's hard to describe. It's just, you know, you get this certain feeling when you go on stage and play the songs.
Would you yourself say you're an artist, or you feel more like musician, or? Does that matter at all?
I play guitar. I don't, you know, make such a big deal about it. But, mm-hmm. you know, I usually say when there's too much, you know, crazy stuff going on, I'm like, I'm just a guy with a guitar that goes crazy sometimes.
Just a normal human being and
enjoy. That's not my... my thing to say if I'm normal or not, but... This is what I do.
And what started you on the music? Like, of course, first you hear the music, and then you think, yeah, I need to do something myself. Was there a special like moment or?
No, I always, you know, music has always been a part of my life, and I come from a music-oriented family, so I always had music close to me. And in Swedish school at the time when I grew up, it was a big support for school kids to
cool.
learn different instruments.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried lots of instruments, and I was playing all of, you know, different stuff all over my childhood. And then I had a break for a couple of years when I just didn't feel like playing at all. You know, I was, you know, into other stuff. And yeah, suddenly I just picked up the guitar and started playing, and quite immediately I formed my first band. So,
mm-hmm. And you feel like making music, or if more people were into making music, that could solve some problems in society?
Well, I think music is good for humanity. You know, whatever type of music it is, you know, it's art in a way, and it's also, you know, way for people to feel free and good about themselves. And yeah, so I think, you know, music is very important for the earth, for people.
Right. So you also sometimes feel like, yeah, I need to hear a party song?
Not really. But I can enjoy, you know, if I'm on a festival or whatever, you know, mixed festival when it's not metal bands. And if you see that this is such a great fucking feeling from the band and the crowd,
mm-hmm.
you can get that feeling. Fucking, this is a, you know, good atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't mean that I like the music, but I like the atmosphere, you know.
Yeah.
And I think that's cool, and I can enjoy, you know, any type of music, you know, if I get that feeling from the, you know, special environment. And
so this is what unites the people. No matter which genre, right?
Music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a feeling.
But of course, then you have lots of, you know, clashes between the scenes. But I see that more. I just don't get it. You know, I never been part of that bullshit.
So it's not so important to say this is this genre and it's better or whatever, but it's just this is all music and it's about the feeling with the crowd and the band.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, whatever kind of music it is, I think people who create music and art is, I can appreciate their, you know, what they are doing and their dedication for the music. But, you know, I maybe don't like the type of music they play or create, but that doesn't really matter to me. You know, I think music as a whole is, you know, it's unity, you know.
Right. Thank you so much for the interview. Thank
You're
you.
Welcome.